Y nada, los dejo con Jessica Nigri. Un aplauso fuerte para Jessica Nigri.
Because it had so many different arms, I had to wear three layers, I had to wear like a black bodysuit, a corset to cover all this because Arendi is super flat chested, and then a super big hat and then like arms and everything. I could only wear that for like 4 hours, but it was so much fun because I was at San Diego Comic Con and nobody knew it was me, and I was like going up and I was like creeping on people, and because my arms were attached, I could touch someone's head but also touch their butt at the same time. So I'd be like, and it would just be like two going on.
Thank you, Tom.
Heard you.
Hello, Jessica.
Hi.
I just wanted to say thank you for coming to Puerto Rico.
Thank you for having me.
In your YouTube channel, I guess your video catalog, all your videos are very fun and very positive, which is awesome. But since we're a little bit more intimate today, do you want to share, maybe your worst day ever at a Comic-Con or a cosplay? Like, you're human, so we all have bad days. You don't share that on your YouTube, but is there anything that you want to share with us today?
I think...
really bad.
If anything, like, probably just days when I'm actually at home, when the internet is just a little bit too mean, you know? And I think about it, and I'm like, man, why am I getting so bummed out? But I have to always remember that the people that are being mean aren't being mean because they personally hate me. There's something going on within their heart that they can't kind of overcome. And so then I end up becoming a punching bag. And so if I think about it like that, I actually feel really kind of sad and sorry for them. And I want to like reach out to them because I'm like, man, I'm sorry that you feel this way. I wish I could help you, because being mean isn't natural. You know, like, we should get together, we should just all love each other. Sorry, I'm spinning this into a positive thing, because that's just being an issue. But once you realize that someone who hates you or doesn't like what you're doing or has something negative to say is only saying that because inside they're hurting, it makes it so much easier. And usually those days end up turning around and becoming that. And I realize, I'm like, there are so many people out there that are so kind and amazing. And usually, like, a really bad day will go from that, and then it'll spin. I'll be like, yay, life is good.
Thanks for the videos.
Thank you.
What you're saying is sometimes you become like a therapist or a psychologist, but with the customer.
Welcome to Jessica's therapy session. What can I help you with?
Who signed in?
Who signed up for my therapy session?
Yeah, for therapy session.
Who's that? I'll be the one on this bed.
Yes, Jessica. What happened to you when you were very young?
Why did it take me so long to make a Dragon Age cosplay? And then if I'm making another Dragon Age cosplay? It took me so long because everyone does Morrigan from Dragon Age, and I thought it would just be cool, super last minute, to do it when I did it. And I really love Morrigan's character. She's super, like, tsundere. Like, you know, she's like, oh, it's not like I like you or anything, you know? Baka. But, I think that's why. It just took me a long time because everyone does it. And then I don't know if I'm going to make a new one. If anything, I'm probably going to make something from The Witcher, so. Thank you.
Hi, Negri. What's up?
What's up?
Of course, a lot of people know you not just for your cosplay, but more recently over the years, you're now a voice actress, especially for Ruby, Cinder, Ruby, and Supersonic on the anime. I was just curious as to, how did it all start? How did you get those opportunities to become a voice actress?
Do you know, it was Monty. It was Monty from Ruby.
Rest in peace.
Monty actually was talking to me at New York Comic Con 2012. And he goes, Jessica, I'm making this anime and I want to show you the characters because I would love for you to cosplay from it. And I jokingly was like, can I be a voice or something? And he kind of goes, that'd be a great idea. So I was like, oh man, I was just joking. But he actually wanted me to be someone so different to my personality so that people would like hear it and then they would go, that's Jessica? Like, what? So he made me like the most evil person in the series, which is so fun. I'm so sorry, Pyrrha. Not really.
Yes.
Sorry, not sorry, Vape Nation. That's kind of how it started. And because of Ruby and because of Rooster Teeth and because of Monty, I was able to have this opportunity to do voice acting, and it was really cool because I don't know if you guys know Miles and Carrie from Rooster Teeth?
Yes.
They're the writers for Miles, Carrie, and Monty. They actually coached me through the entire recording session so that they could, like, like get the character that they wanted, and it was so much fun. And because of that, I got approached by Sentai Filmworks to do Super Sonico, and then after that, I got approached by Super Sonico, the video game with Nitro Plus, so it's been amazing!
Thank you.
What inspired you to be a cosplayer?
So when I first started, I didn't know what cosplay was. I Googled what cosplay was, and it was Yaya Han. I saw pictures of Yaya everywhere, and I was like, oh my gosh, this lady is incredibly talented. I want to be like her. She's all over the place, she's super mega hot, and she's doing all this. And I also wanted to kind of create more fan art of my cosplay for like other people, like what is it, the companies to see and stuff like that. So I made like a Gears of War costume, and the company, Epic Games, like noticed me, and I was like, oh my god, senpai, you know, for Gears of War. And so that kind of just is what perpetuated it. And I didn't know what I was doing when I first started, but someone said it's costume play, and I was like, play, so like have a good time and have fun with it, right? And so that's what I did. Yeah, that's fun.
Which one will be beside yourself? Your favorite cosplayer out there?
My favorite cosplayer out there?
Yeah, I mean, beside.
Oh my gosh. There's so many. Like, there's Kamui, or like Svetlana, she's amazing. There's Lightning Cosplay, there's Yaya Han, there's, oh my gosh, there's Leanna. Did anyone see Leanna today? I love Leanna. There's so many. That's like asking me to pick my like favorite child or something. Ryan?
Hi. I wanted to ask if you're gonna finish your Cho'Gath, or if you're planning to do like Rengar possibly also?
Yes, I'm definitely finishing Cho'Gath.
Looking forward to that.
I have to. It's just because it's so stupid. Do you guys play League of Legends?
Yeah. Yeah.
So you know, sexy gentleman Cho'Gath, yeah.
Definitely looking forward to that.
Actually, these are what the horns were from originally, and I took them off and I put them up here because I made Cho'Gath. And then I wanted to like remake it to make it a lot better, so don't worry, it's coming and it's gonna be so weird.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Hi.
First of all, I'm a huge fan of Ruby and Cinder. I'm sorry, Pear, but Cinder's awesome.
Thank you.
My question would be, what kind of tips can you have for a beginner cosplayer like myself who wants to make a Genderman Yang, for example?
You want to make a Genderman?
Yang.
Yang? Ooh, you could definitely look online and look up different YouTube tutorials and stuff. Google is your best friend. If you want to just Google the crap out of like cosplay and stuff. No, seriously, there's been Genderman Yang art that's on like Tumblr and Pinterest and stuff, and you could like look at that as like a what is it called? A basic reference. And then you can go from there. That'll be awesome. That'll be really cool. I'm excited to see that. Just Google everything. And don't worry about what people say.
I don't care what people say.
Good, that's good. I like that.
I've got too many photo jokes already.
Good man. F the haters.
I don't know you, but I like his voice.
It's like Demon Soldier,
yeah.
Right? It should be in radio.
Have you ever considered like being a part of anime series, like be part of, you know, like in an anime, like you have your own anime and you can voice act with it? Oh,
I don't know, that's a cool idea.
He might have the story.
Oh my gosh, you have a story?
Yeah, you could have a story.
Do you want to write like a fan fiction and just like make it really strange?
Yeah.
Could it be like the cooking one where people eat stuff and their clothes blow up?
You like, could be a zombie apocalypse, you could be a hero.
Yeah. One of those Borat slinkinis, like the whole time.
He can be in it too. I really like Ryan, but I saw him on one of your YouTube videos. He's so funny.
Oh, Ryan, you're so funny. He's gone.
He's resting. He's
working. He's like laying on the floor in the back. Cool.
So if you have your own anime. I'm gonna look into
it. And thank you for
being here and for coming.
Thank you for having me.
I really hope you will come in the future.
I will come every day.
Sunday.
My perfect Sunday, oh my gosh, a huge burrito and video games all day, right? What's your favorite food? Like favorite Puerto Rican food?
Well, I was going to say burgers.
Burger? Burger, yeah. Burger, yeah.
If I had to say
what? I feel like there's like rivalry going on.
Hi, so I'm like super nervous right now.
Don't be nervous, I'm nervous too.
Okay, well, so I just wanted to know that I love your cosplay music videos. I think they're amazing, all the editing and the music.
Thank you!
They're just great. So I wanted to ask you, you just reached 4 million likes on Facebook. So congratulations on that. Addison!
I can't think about it because it freaks me out.
Thank you. I'm sorry, but my question is, how does it feel having such a huge following like that?
It's insane. Huh? I don't know what to do with myself. Well, maybe now I can like talk to Markiplier and I can be like, hey, Markiplier, notice me. But, right? I actually tweeted him once this like really weird video and like everyone tweeted it and I'm sure he saw it, but I think he just probably thinks I'm really weird now. So now I don't really want to like reach out to him. I'm scared to meet him because I feel like he's going to be like, oh yeah, you're that girl, huh?
Probably reach like 7 million in like 3 months.
Sweet Jesus, no.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Hi, I love your stocking. I love you. I love you too.
I love everyone too.
What Pokemon do you want to cosplay with?
I would love to cosplay Ho-Oh.
Ho-Oh!
Not the reason why you think, though. I just want to be Ho-Oh so people can be like, oh, look, it's Ho.
I can be your Lumia.
Thank you. I'm sorry, I'm so basic. Oh, I'd be dumb.
Hi.
Hi. It's Amanda, right?
Yeah.
Hey, what's up?
How do you go about choosing, like, who you're going to cosplay? Like,
how do I know? What?
Like,
or do you,
the characters, like, which, how do you choose?
Yeah. What characters? It's pretty hard sometimes. A lot of times, recently, I haven't found characters that I've really, really wanted to do that are female, or, I feel like I want to do more elaborate male costumes more. So I've actually had my friend Zach Fisher, who designed Deathwing and Kindred for me, because it's sometimes I just want to do a character that nobody else has done, an original design that like no one's done, so it's like, so I can just do it for me and it can just be this like really cool thing. Because I feel like a lot of the times when I cosplay characters that already exist, there's already someone who's cosplayed it so well that I don't want to do it. You know cosplayers, you know that feeling. Like, you see someone do one and you're like, man, I don't want to make this anymore. That video is way better, you know? So that's kind of how I've been picking lately, is I've just taken any character that I really like that's elaborate. It doesn't matter if it's like an animal or if it's a man or if it's a woman. And then I'll have Zach adapt it and kind of change it to the way that I want it to be. And then we'll do that. So he's actually designed that Berserker Totoro that I'm doing right now. So it's going to be sick.
Excited. Thank you. I love
it.
Thank you.
Hello.
I would like to know, when you go to a convention, how do you decide which cosplay to take with you?
So for this one?
Well,
or just in general? Usually if it's a convention that I'm not working, I'll wear like super elaborate costumes so that I can like run around and take photos and stuff. But if it's for a convention where I'm meeting people, I always want to wear really comfy stuff because I like to hug. You guys know this. I'm a hugger. So that's usually how I choose. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, no worries. Left shark.
Hi. Well, I'm a cosplayer myself, and I like to build full body armors. Today I'm doing some relaxed like this, but I have a friend. He's wearing a Genos cosplay. Will you turn on?
Genos?
Genos?
I see him right there. Ryan, that's a really dope Genos. Go look over there. He's glowing.
And,
somebody wake up Ryan.
I know, Ryan just got up on the floor. Look at that, it's amazing.
And,
he's running.
Like
Master Roshi, that'd be so cool. Or like a ball cap, and I'm like, unlimited. You can be whoever you want to be, when you want to be it. Be a boy, be a girl, be anything! Hi, no pressure!
What's the weirdest cosplay you ever have done?
What's the weirdest cosplay I've ever made?
None of them, because she's not weird. All of her is love.
All of them are weird. I don't know. I honestly don't know. What's like the weirdest thing I've done? Right? No. Everything on the internet. I don't know. I'll have to make something weird. Like a sexy Moses. For you to do that. Is that good? Oh, yeah. Alright, we got this. I saw a sexy Gandalf. Where is she? Oh, she's over there. Yeah. Hello, monkey. What's up?
Stewie speaking. Stewie.
What?
Stewie.
Okay. What is your favorite Hayao Miyazaki movie?
One more time.
Hayao. What is your favorite Hayao Miyazaki movie? Studio Ghibli. Studio Ghibli.
Princess Mononoke. Yeah. Can we just for a second take a moment because Ryan hasn't seen any Miyazaki movie.
Just in case, if you don't want too many followers, try not to make scary games, you know, scary gameplays, because like, you will have a lot of followers then. Just in case.
I don't know what'd you say?
That you said that you don't know how to go to too many followers, so if you want to win a lot of more followers, try not to play scary games, or you will have a lot of freaking followers. Yeah, the best video.
Yeah, I should have known about too much period now.
Oh, just one more blur.
Sorry.
Question.
Yes.
On the following two games, Monster Hunter and Dark Souls, do you plan in the future making cosplays of those?
Dark Souls.
So there?
I like Dark Souls is really cool. Yeah.
Well, I'll take my leave.
Oh, okay, oh, sorry.
Thank you.
Hurry up, people.
Hi, Jessica.
Hi, Kirito. You're overpowered.
Are you planning to do another cosplay duo with Ryan?
Yeah! Ryan, what are we cosplaying next? What are we cosplaying next? What? Oh, One Punch Man. I think I want to be Saitama.
Oh.
That could be the weirdest cosplay! I'll just be super indifferent about everything and try to kill like mosquitoes.
Considering my input.
Hi.
In terms of planning
stay motivated. I think I've started like 5 different costumes and just totally bailed on them. I started Dark Flame Shyvana from League of Legends like years ago, and I never finished it because I don't know, when you get, cosplayers know that when you start working on something and you run into something that's like really hard or difficult, you just want to quit. And you just want to throw everything away because you're like, I don't know how to make pants, you know? So, yeah, you know, she does. Yeah, exactly, you like criticize, you're your own worst enemy when it comes to like, you're criticizing your art and everything. So it's really hard, but lots of energy drinks and Netflix. Honestly, that's how we do it.
I'm doing everything wrong then.
Yeah. Just binging anime.
Boyfriend, she's a bigger fan than that. I wanted to ask, I'm saving up to take a trip to Japan, and I wanted to know how easy or hard it is to move around Japan. Do you need to know Japanese to actually do stuff over there? How easy it is to move around Japan? Do you need to know English?
To like navigate around Japan? Is it?
Yeah.
It's actually really tourist friendly. A lot of the like subways and stuff have English everywhere, and it's really really easy. Like they the train stops are super easy to get to. It says Akihabara in like English and Japanese. And in Tokyo, it's really easy. Yeah. The further you go out from the center of like Tokyo and the hub, it gets a little harder, and it's really cool. You, but if you're just going to Tokyo and you just want to walk around, it's so easy. And the people are so, so, so nice. Like, you'll come back to where you're from and you're just like, why is nobody, like, why is everybody not Japanese? We're all the kawaii girls! It's so easy.
Thank you.
Yeah, you just say, notice me, senpai, to every Japanese person. They're just like,
quickly, cinco preguntas más, five more questions.
see, I'm just gonna be like, do you believe in destiny? It's so messed up.
I would do that as my destiny. And my question is, first of all, thank you for coming here. I hope you have a lot of fun, enjoy your time, and blessings to you, a lot of prosperity in your future for both of you.
Thank you.
And thank you for all my Polaroids. Yes, and I hope you like the cookies. Enjoy them.
Put them on my ceiling.
Yeah, I think we're gonna be like, we're gonna
snatch it. Can we do like, wait. We're going to ask Phoenix a big round of applause to come into stage. We're gonna do two things. We're gonna say goodbye to her, and then we'll do some surprise thing.
Surprise?
Jessica O'Brien, thank you so much. We hope you're having a good time here in Puerto Rico. So I just want to thank all of you for coming and showing. And let's give Jessica O'Brien a nice big Boricua.
Una, dos, y nos fuimos.